Hello and welcome back to Patrick Boyle on Finance, where we learn all about quantitative finance. Today we'll be discussing what correlation is and why it matters to traders and investors. We'll learn why correlation is so high right now and why investors might care. Keep watching till the end of the video and I'll explain a trading strategy where traders can profit from rises and falls in stock market correlation. Okay, so here's an interesting statistic for you. Right now, in June 2020, the S&P 500 index's three-month realized correlation has settled around the 0.8 level, its highest in about 8 years, even though other gauges of market stress, such as the VIX index, has returned to normal levels. The divergence between these indicators suggests that investors continue to focus on just one main driver, the global coronavirus pandemic, making it harder for active fund managers to beat their benchmarks. Essentially, it means that all stocks are rising and falling together, and it doesn't really matter which ones you pick to invest in. Correlation is a statistical measure that indicates the extent to which two or more variables fluctuate together. It measures the degree to which two phenomena are related to one another. A positive correlation indicates the extent to which variables increase or decrease in parallel. A negative correlation indicates the extent to which one variable increases as the other decreases. Uncorrelated variables have a covariance of zero. If two variables are uncorrelated, there's no linear relationship between them. Correlation is one of the most useful statistics to a trader. This video, by the way, is based on my newest book, which is called Statistics for the Trading Floor, and it has been released a couple of days ago on Amazon.com. I'll put a link to it in the description of the video below. And if you're interested, you can also check out my other books. I have one on derivatives and one on corporate finance. The S&P 500 index's three-month realized correlation began the year with a value of around 0.2. The gauge of how closely the top stocks in the S&P 500 move in relation to one another spiked to 0.85 in mid-March, the peak of the coronavirus sell-off, before steadying down at around 0.8. A maximum possible correlation of 1 would signify that all stocks are moving in precise lockstep with each other. During periods of high correlation over the last decade, people have blamed the rise of index funds or quantitative trading algorithms that rely on historical relationships and end up blindly reinforcing those correlations. Investors argued that something was broken in the pricing and capital allocation functions of the stock market, and that all of the different stocks simply rose and fell together, trading like the same stock. This time the argument is different. The current explanation for high correlations in the stock market are that in February there was an economy, then in March the economy shut down, and eventually there either will be an economy or there won't. If there is an economy, then different companies will have different earnings, but if there's not, then no companies will have any earnings. Obviously, every company will be better off if there is an economy than if there isn't. Your bet on whether there will be an economy and when will almost certainly determine whether you think any particular company's stock is over or underpriced. Particular differences in the outlook for specific companies have become, in this environment, essentially irrelevant. This is, of course, an oversimplification. The S&P correlation is 0.8, not 1.0, and certain companies that are holding up well in this environment are, of course, performing better than the most hard-hit sectors. But overall, this might be the correct rough model. If you're an active fund manager who spent the last few years arguing that index funds are fine in rising markets with high correlations, but in more complicated times investors will need the human intuition of active fund management, this outcome is far from ideal. You were hoping for the market to go back to normal with some stocks going up and others going down so that you could pick the ones that go up while index funds were forced to also hold the ones that go down. Instead, the bull market broke in a way that ended up increasing correlations. In early 2020, all companies were overwhelmed by the same novel risk. They sold off together and then they recovered together based upon global government interventions. One thing that sometimes confuses traders about correlation is that two assets can actually be very highly correlated and stay that way, yet one asset might yield a plus 50% return in a year, while the second asset could yield a minus 50% return over the same period. The reason for this confusion is that traders often misunderstand what correlation means and doesn't mean. Correlation is best thought of as representing the general directional relationship between two assets. If two assets start out with a price of, we'll say, $20, and every time the first asset goes up by 1%, the second asset goes up by 5%, and that ratio of 5 to 1 is consistent, the correlation will be 1, even though the second asset is producing 5 times the return of the first asset. In addition to this, there can be very high correlations between assets where one asset has a decay. Using the same example as above, let's say that the first asset lost 20 cents of value every day in addition to its relationship with the second asset. There can still be an extremely high correlation coefficient despite the first asset falling to zero while the second asset rises in price. A common real-world example of this effect is levered ETFs. I made a video about them a couple of weeks ago. The double short levered real estate ETF in 2008 was almost perfectly negatively correlated with the underlying real estate ETF, yet ended up losing almost all of its value. If you had just shorted the real estate ETF rather than buying the double short ETF, you would have actually made money. So why does high correlation upset active managers? The idea is that when correlations are high, investors should spend more time worrying about the things that affect all stocks rather than the things that affect the differences between particular stocks, which is usually what active managers focus on, in particular fundamental managers. When correlations are low, doing research to find the best stocks will be more valuable than when they are high, where having an accurate opinion on how quickly the economy will reopen is significantly more useful. So, can traders trade correlation? Yes, they can, actually. Correlation trading is an advanced trading strategy in which the investor bets on the future realized correlation amongst the member stocks of a given stock market index. The goal in trading correlation is to predict when future realized correlation amongst the stocks of a particular index will be greater or less than the implied correlation level, which can be backed out from the pricing of options or other derivatives on the index and the stocks that make up the index. Due to the nature of diversification, the volatility of a portfolio of securities is less than or equal to the average volatility of the individual securities that make up the portfolio. The lower the correlation is between the individual securities, the greater the diversification benefits, and the lower the overall portfolio volatility. Thus, when expected correlation is very low, index volatility will be a lot lower than the volatility of the individual index members. And when expected correlation is very high, index volatility will be closer to the average volatility of the individual securities that make up the index. To sell correlation, a trader can either sell index options while buying a basket of options on the individual stocks that make up the index, or sell a variance swap on the index and buy variance swaps on the individual constituents, or sell a correlation swap. To buy correlation, a trader would just do the opposite of that. Okay, so hit the like and subscribe buttons, and if you found this video useful, check out my book on Amazon, which is linked to in the description below. Bye.